This is the bus taken by KLM Flight 808 when flying from Taipei to Amsterdam. For China Airlines Flight 73, however, it uses a wholly different route. In another example, flights between Tokyo and LA use different routes for westbound than eastbound. This makes the world's flight paths to be quite messy, and there are a few reasons for that. This is the Earth's jet streams. They are fast and narrow air currents in the atmosphere flowing from west to east. When an aircraft flying with the flow of the jet streams, it has an extra force pushing it forward. And since jet streams can travel at speeds greater than 180 km an hour, flight time can be dramatically affected by either flying with or against the flow of the jet streams. In the early example, the flights from LA to Tokyo use what is known as the Great Circle Route, which is the shortest route possible between two points on the surface of a sphere, while eastbound flights use the jet stream route. Even though the latter is longer, its flight time is actually almost 2 hours quicker than the former. Jet streams are one of the biggest factors that is taken into consideration when plotting the routes for long-haul flights. By the way, if you're wondering why this is the shortest route by distance, remember that the Earth is a sphere, and for some cases, the shortest distance on a sphere translates to a curve on a 2D map. If there's one thing affecting the world's flight paths more than jet streams, it's geopolitics. Countries with large territories and strategic locations can use their airspace to earn revenue, strong-arm negotiations, and act as a punitive measure against unfriendly administration. In April 2018, the United States and its allies launched missile strikes in Syria aimed at curbing that country's chemical weapon programs. Russia is an ally of Syrian President Bashar al-Assad, and it just so happened that the US Airlines' rights to fly over Russia was about to expire a few days after the airstrikes. The Russians retaliated by cancelling a planned meeting in Washington to discuss renewing overflight agreement between the two countries. This is a big problem for US Airlines as Eastern Russia provides the shortest and cheapest route to Asia. For a while, American Airlines flights from Chicago to Beijing and Dallas to Hong Kong had to be diverted to Los Angeles to be refueled. These supposedly non-stop flights were forced to avoid Russian airspace and took the longer, costlier route. Fortunately, the overflight agreement was later renewed. In June 2017, Saudi Arabia, UAE, Egypt, and a few other countries severed diplomatic relations with Qatar and banned all Qatari airplanes from using their airspace. As a result, Qatar Airways had to divert its flights to Africa and Europe via Iran, paying exorbitant overflight fees and adding up to 5 hours of flight time. Earlier, we saw how a China Airlines flight uses a longer path when flying between Taipei and Amsterdam. This is because China Airlines is based in Taiwan, and all Taiwan-based airlines are denied access to airspace over mainland China due to the existing conflict between the two governments. Another factor is safety, more specifically weather and war. The most intense and turbulent storms can create massive cloud structures with tops that can reach over 60,000 feet, well above the cruising altitude of commercial airplanes. So en route flights usually seek to go around them to minimize the risk and to avoid the unpleasant turbulence. Volcano eruptions occur a lot less often than thunderstorms, but is even more dangerous to aircraft. Volcanic ash can clog the engines, causing them to malfunction. That is exactly what happened to British Airways Flight 9, as it was flying from Kuala Lumpur to Perth on the night of 24th of June 1982. A series of eruptions over a few months of Mount Galunggung in West Java, Indonesia, had formed ash clouds up to 16 km high. First, the flight crew noticed an unusual effect on the windscreen similar to St. Elmo's fire. Then, thick smoke with an ominous odor of sulfur began to accumulate in the passenger cabin. Soon after that, one by one, all four engines began surging and then flamed out. Oxygen masks were later dropped for the passengers. Some of them even started to write letters to their loved ones, thinking that they were about to die. At this moment, even without a clue of what was actually happening, the captain made one of the most legendary pilot announcements ever. In an overly calm manner, he said,
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. We have a small problem.
All four engines have stopped. We're doing our damnedest to get it under control. I trust you are not in too much distress.
Amazingly, all four engines then came back on just 15 minutes later, when the plane had glided from 37,000 feet to 12,000 feet. After the molten ash that had clogged the engine started to solidify and break off.
Hundreds of passengers are feared dead after a Malaysian Airlines jet crashed in Ukraine.
On 17 July 2014, Malaysia Airlines Flight 17 was shot down by a surface-to-air missile while flying over eastern Ukraine, killing nearly 300 people. There was an ongoing conflict in that region between Ukrainian military and Russian-backed separatists. Even though the region was made a no-fly zone, the flight restriction was only up to 32,000 feet and the plane was flying at 33,000 feet. Other airlines were doing the same thing, but there were some airlines that avoided the region altogether. Most of the decisions about a route are taken by airlines, but they must avoid no-fly zones set by the relevant authorities. They include the national aviation bodies of the carrier's home nation and of all the other countries that a plane is flying over. Last but not least, some no-fly zones exist not for the safety of the planes flying over them, but for the safety of the people or buildings on the ground. Some examples are the White House, Taj Mahal, Buckingham Palace, and even Disneyland.